pieces, because this extremism that we see today was actually, as you know quite well, first developed in Afghanistan, and the American government and the Saudis started supporting them. Their school books and the books that they used to build up their ideology were actually first published in the United States. They were printed in the United States and taken to Afghanistan. So they used Al-Qaeda and later what became the Taliban in Afghanistan for strategic purposes. So, you know, if it's a religious thing, it's their religion because they own it, they and the Saudis. But this has nothing to do with religion. After all, the secular West, they are responsible for more death and destruction across the globe and in Europe itself in the First and Second World War than any, you know, other country anywhere else in the world. If Hitler has committed atrocities or Churchill has committed atrocities, and you combine them, all their atrocities, it's infinitely greater than, you know, what other countries have done. What Hitler did to Europeans, Churchill did to the rest of the world. So, yeah. But again, the Europeans seem to think that, or ordinary Europeans are being told that the problem is elsewhere. No, I mean, and if one thing that I've said a couple of times to some to Western reporters is that if you really don't like strange looking people like me with strange sounding names like mine in your country, the best thing to do is to stop bombing these countries.
Thank you.
To stop imposing sanctions, and you know, we'd all be sitting in our hometowns drinking coffee or having tea and living our own lives. But when you destroy Libya, when you destroy country after country, when you plunder Africa, when you plunder Latin America, well, then people are going to go to the American border, across the American-Mexican border. People are going to cross the Mediterranean into Europe. It's quite obvious that their own policies that have created these catastrophes. But it is all about imperialism and empire. So they're not serving the interests of their own people. They're serving the interests of the elites, you know, the military industrial complex and these things that have been well documented and explained. So I don't think you and I need to go into that. But these are just justifications, these arguments that they put forward in order to pursue the same policies that are bringing down their own system. I mean, Trump claims that, I think he said, $7 trillion have been wasted in this region. He said this 2-3 years ago. According to those estimates, then it must be something like $10 trillion now. Well, regardless of the nature of capitalism and how horrible capitalism and liberalism and neoliberalism is, and we're seeing it now in the United States, and how, you know, and of course, and this is, this is also going to begin to make it more difficult for Western regimes to use and Western media to use propaganda to convince their own people, because people in the United States no longer trust their own media when it comes to issues in the United States. So that is in itself a good thing. There's a greater awareness now in general, which I think is quite positive. But that aside, the bailout, which is, you know, trillions of dollars stolen from, you know, ordinary people and given to the rich. Basically, that's what has happened, both now and in 2008.
Right.
If you combine 2008 and what happened just a few months ago, and which is ongoing, it is less than the amount of money that the United States wasted on its so-called, you know, unending war against terrorism.